I'm sure most of you have heard of people earning more money in decentralized finance, otherwise known as DeFi, compared to the traditional banking system. Because like the DeFi supporters like to say, there's no middleman, right? But the problem for the vast majority of people is that the DeFi space is super complicated and, let's be honest, extremely risky and can be volatile. Let's take a look at the example of staking a cryptocurrency for rewards. Staking basically means committing your cryptocurrency to a blockchain network to help secure the network and earning a percentage rate reward back of that cryptocurrency over time. Since you are earning that cryptocurrency as a reward, you're at the whim of the price volatility that most crypto assets deal with right now. For example, let's say you stake 10 Ethereum, and as a reward, you receive 1 Ethereum back. During a crypto bear market, the price of 1 Ethereum drops, so the reward you receive at the bear market is less in terms of dollar amount than what you would have normally received in a normal market. So this is where the Anchor protocol comes in. The Anchor protocol is a savings platform built on top of the Terra blockchain. According to the white paper, Anchor protocol's main goal is to become the gold standard for blockchain passive income. People can deposit Terra USD, otherwise known as UST. UST is a stablecoin pegged to the US dollar at 1-to-1, meaning 1 UST equals 1 US dollar. Depositors are currently paid out a 19% interest rate in UST. 19% interest rate is actually an insane number when you compare that to the traditional bank savings account rate of 0.06%. So how does the Anchor protocol achieve a 19% interest rate to depositors? In order to achieve this, the Anchor protocol lends out the money deposited to people who want to borrow the money. Borrowers pay an interest rate on their loans. The interest rate the borrowers pay is calculated by an algorithm that is largely dependent on the current borrowing demand and deposit supply. Generally speaking, if there is more demand for people borrowing money, then the interest rate will be higher for the borrowers. And on the other hand, if there are more people depositing money, then the borrow interest rate will be lower to incentivize people to borrow. To ensure that the borrowers don't just take the loan and disappear, the borrower needs to put down a collateral of either Ethereum or Luna, which is the token of the Terra blockchain. Technically, the borrowers put down a bonded asset version of Ethereum and Luna called B-Asset. We won't get into the technical details of how a B-Asset works in this video. But the important thing to note here is that the B asset acts like a staked asset, in which holders of the B asset can earn a percentage rate reward back. The B asset collateral that Anchor Protocol holds helps stabilize the interest rate given to depositors by allocating the B asset stake rewards back to the depositors. Borrowers could only borrow a certain percentage of their B asset collateral amount. For example, if they put down $100 worth of Ethereum as collateral, then they can only borrow 60% of the collateral, which means they can only borrow $60 worth of UST. To quickly sum things up here, Anchor Protocol earns money on the interest that borrowers pay out on the loans, and Anchor Protocol also earns through the B assets they have in collateral through their stake rewards. Furthermore, to protect the principal of depositors, Anchor Protocol implemented a liquidation protocol. If a borrower's loan is at risk, then the liquidation protocol will liquidate the collateral to pay off the loan. Moving on, for people who want to take part in the roadmap of Anchor Protocol, they can also acquire the Anchor token, otherwise known as ANC, which is Anchor Protocol's governance token. The more ANC one holds, the more voting power they will have. ANC holders can vote on things such as modifying the borrower's interest rate formula. Lastly, to incentivize borrowers, Anchor Protocol gradually distributes ANC tokens every block to stablecoin borrowers, proportional to the amount they borrowed. Incentivizing more borrowers brings more buying pressure to the ANC token, which causes the price of the token to go up, and thus further increasing borrowers' incentives. While Anchor Protocol on paper sounds amazing, just like any other DeFi projects, there are of course some risks. The first risk factor that I want to talk about is security. Just like any other blockchain, there might be a bug in the code that allows a hacker to steal funds. Fortunately, Anchor Protocol has been audited by a third-party blockchain security company called Certik. And they have an additional $1 million bounty program for anyone who finds any critical issues. The second risk factor that I would like to highlight could be a crypto flash crash. If the entire crypto market drops more than 20% in a day for long periods, the people who borrow money on the Anchor protocol could be at risk of losing their collateral. Another factor that might lower the interest rate given to depositors is yield deficiency. Currently, deposits are growing at a much higher multiple compared to the amount that is borrowed. Remember, deposited amount is paid out 90% by Anchor protocol. And currently, the borrowed interest rate that borrowers need to repay is currently 12.52%. Even though Anchor does generate income through the stake rewards of the collateral, that is not enough to cover the wide gap of deposited versus borrowed amount, which means Anchor protocol needs to pull from its yield reserve. Most recently, on February 18, 2022, Anchor protocol pulled a rabbit out of the hat by injecting $400 million into their yield reserve, which should help Anchor protocol maintain the 90% rate given to depositors for now. Summing things up, Anchor protocol allows you to deposit stablecoins and earn a steady interest rate of 19%. Since the deposited money is in the form of stablecoins, your money is liquid, so you can withdraw it at any time. The 90% interest rate most likely won't last forever, and remember, even the great Warren Buffett only averaged 15% annual return over the last decade. Thank you all so much for watching, and please let me know in the comments below what your take is on the Anchor protocol. Appreciate you all, and until next time.